Well, the more we learn about our universe, the more we find that the secular theories about how stars formed, how galaxies exist and how they formed, and how our solar system formed and why it exists, are just a huge package of just-so stories that don't work. Here's an article from NASA talking about rogue planets. Guess what they've discovered? They think free-floating planets may be more common than stars. Now, the secular camp's theory about how our solar system and how planets form has long been established. They believe that an accretion disk left behind by an exploding star that has coalesced into a disk-like mass, and this coalesced then into planets orbiting the center remnant of that exploded star, and this is how our solar system formed. But now they think that free-floating planets, which have no star that they orbit, may be more common than stars. The discovery indicates that there are more free-floating Jupiter mass planets than can be seen. The team estimates there are about twice as many of them as there are as stars. In addition, these worlds are thought to be at least as common as planets that orbit stars. This adds up to hundreds of billions of lone planets in our Milky Way galaxy alone. Go figure. Wait a minute. I thought planets were created from an accretion disk. A star explodes, material ejects from it in a disk shape instead of a flat shape, a spherical shape, and then this hot material coalesces into planets, which orbit that remnant of the star, the center of it, what was left. I thought that's how solar systems formed, how our solar system formed. But maybe not. Maybe there are just lots of free-floating planets out there that weren't created by any accretion disk at all. How do you explain that with your evolutionist presumptions about the origin of things in our universe? See, it doesn't work. The more we discover, that the secular theories about our solar system and galaxies and planets, none of it works. It just doesn't work because we constantly find a body of evidence that refutes their assumptions. Now here's more. First planets around sun like stars in a cluster. This is from the Jet Propulsion Laboratory, California Institute of Technology. They state now that they've discovered that there are suns that orbit each other in kind of a strange rotational pattern that don't rotate around anything. They just rotate around each other. And they've got planets flying around there. Kind of doesn't match any of the models that the secular camp has for the origin of things in our universe, does it? They're constantly discovering more and more strange things that contradict the secular theories about how everything came into being. But this is the funniest of all. They state, there may be more Jupiter-sized planets than stars. Free-floating, just floating off around through space, not orbiting any sun, any star. How'd they come into being? Well, here's what they claim. Oh, they've got to have a just so story for that, right? Well, here it is. Another body comes flying through the solar system of that star planet, and because of its gravitational pull, it causes that planet to get pulled out of orbit, ejected from the solar system, and hurled off into space. Does that make any sense to you? No, and it really doesn't make any sense to them either. But they have to have some story to explain it away, and this is the only thing they can think of. What else could explain them? They had to have formed in a solar system in a galaxy, right? I mean, a solar system with an accretion disk, right? They had to have been orbiting a sun, a star, right? So that means they got pulled away from it and thrown off into outer space. That's what they have to believe if they stick to their paradigm, their idea that planets are formed from an accretion disk remnant of a blown-up star. So they claim that these things just were ejected off into space. But that doesn't make any sense, does it? What do you think really would happen if a gravitational force of some planet came close enough to another planet to kind of hurt, move its orbit? Would it just cause that planet to be ejected off into outer space? No, it would not. Even a layperson who is not an astronomer can see the absurdity of that. At most, it would cause the planet's orbit to change to a strange ellipse, but it would not pull it away from the larger mass, which is the star it supposedly orbits, right? No, it wouldn't pull it, steal it away from the star. At best, it would change its orbit some, into a pretty wild orbit, probably. Maybe a strong ellipse. Wouldn't steal it away. Kind of send it flying off into space. Do you realize the energy required for that? It's nuts. These theories don't work because there's no common sense to them. There's not even any physics that works for them. But they've got to have something because they have to say that it formed on its own. That there was no creator for the universe and that God didn't create anything. That's why none of their theories work, because they're going against the truth, which is creation. Just thought I'd share this with you. Just one more of the countless evidences that refute the secular ideas about the origin of our universe and our solar system and our galaxies. You can study their models and you'll find nothing but holes. Well, we can't explain how such and such, but it happened. And then they have to make up some wacky idea, like a big body comes flying through a solar system, a solar system, and causes a planet to become ejected and fly off through space. Well, even if that were so, listen to what they say. The team estimates there are twice as many of them as stars. That would mean there would have to have been in the past an unbelievable amount of planets orbiting suns that got slung off into outer space. Can you see that? Why don't we see any of these today? If there were so many solar systems out there with planets, that these planets were there so that they could get dragged off out of their orbits and slung off into outer space, why don't we see all these solar systems now? Where are all the other ones? Because they've only located what they believe to be a handful of solar systems in the universe. So where are these hundreds and hundreds and hundreds and hundreds, thousands and millions of them? They say this adds up to hundreds of billions of lone planets. Well, where's the hundreds of billions of solar systems they were slung off from? You see, their wacky theories to explain things away don't make any sense at all. They have nothing to support their idea. All we know is this. The planets are there, they're free-floating, and it's likely there's a whole lot of them. So how do they explain them away? They got slung out of their solar systems, which don't exist. We can't find them. Interesting, isn't it? Holes, holes, holes. Theories that don't work and have no support. But hey, God didn't create anything, right? Till next time.